Oh my god. Well, this is a different kind of rush than I had in mind.
What? What?
He's gonna make sure nothing what? Is ever...
What the... What? This is... This... What somebody are... tell Haas that this does not actually make sense. There's no reason to invest 600 minerals and buy a lot.
Yeah, you're laughing, but he has practiced this, Ben. So you can laugh all you want, but there's probably a pretty good shot that this is going to work.
This is never going to work.
Oh, well, we'll see. I'm pretty sure that he has practiced this before. Jadon is losing a lot of mining time.
Is that a gateway?
Yes. Maybe this is actually part of the strat, so the Zealots can run through. One cannon is about to finish up. Jadon will be absolutely trapped on two bases, Ben.
He can just kill the rocks. He can build a spine crawler and then kill the rocks
that's
and
true.
Go off
I forgot
the
about the rocks. Still, though, this cannon is going to do some work. This wall is up. More he cancels the gate. Okay. This is a bizarre cannon rush. Someone should tell Haas that there is a more economic way to do this. However, it might still work.
This cannot work.
Well, if these three cannons... there's only one cannon right now. Actually, Jaina can start canceling some. He's going to drop pylons here as well.
I don't think that last spine crawler is ever going to finish.
In the blink of an eye. Or like on the edge. In the closing moments, Ben, I think that Jadon is in a little bit of trouble.
This
you started laughing.
Work.
But I see three cannons right now shooting at spine crawlers. I see spine crawlers being canceled at rapid speed. I see a Protoss with more workers than a Zerg.
And there is no way for Jadon to get another hatchery.
Unless he kills the rocks. Well, Ben. Do the commentary, please.
I'm trying to find the words. But, it looks like this hatchery's dead. Jadon is going to have a couple of spine crawlers on the low ground, but he can't actually reposition them to fight the cannon. He ends up actually canceling one.
And now Hess is like, cool, I'll drop a gateway. I'm going to expand.
There is literally no way for Jadon to secure a base now. But how much did he have to spend for this to work? No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 buildings, plus at least two more that were canceled.
Yeah, but this is the type of cannon rush that you cannot just cancel your hatch and expand somewhere else.
You're right.
This is the type of cannon rush that if it goes up, you're stuck. And Jadon knew that, so Jadon was like, well, I can't have this happening. So Jadon was not mining all the time. And he tried at all costs to defend it, while normally you can just be as a Zerg like, to hell with it. I'm going to take my base somewhere else, and that's completely fine. But Jadon had nothing out on the map.
The follow-up for Haas is almost certainly going to be just a big immortal push. But there's the warp in.
Yeah, it's how many? 19 against 19. This is okay. Plus one is not ready yet. If there's ever a moment to fight, this might be the moment. I think that you can still drop good force suits, I guess.
I think that's a pretty reasonable fight for Jadon. But does he have enough? Is there enough Zerglings here? Do we see the spine crawler repositioning? Queens are trying to help fight. But there's going to be another warp in, and there are not. Oh my god. This cannot be happening right now. The queens are being transfused very well. The last. Of the initial zealots go down.
Zerglings is not good enough, man. You really need roaches against this. Haas with a lot of zealots in the main base. Spinecrawlers are being repositioned. Jadon is microing for his WCS America.
The queens can right click on that warp prism.
There's a pylon in his base as well, man.
It's done. That's it.
Eight more zealots with plus one being wiped into the main base. And the upset of all upsets so far in WCS America, perhaps in any WCS region, is that Jadon is going to be our first player to be eliminated of WCS Group D. What?
Unbelievable. Hats off to Haas for finding a way to make it happen. Unorthodox play, highly aggressive play.
He's going to do this up the ramp with double pylon there, and Violet's not reacting. Okay, he's pulling a drone now. The drone's coming over. He's going to scout this. You can't get in there, though. And the second probe coming in on the low ground, he's going to scout this pylon.
Violet is already entering Haas's world here, and it's not even a lucky scout here by Haas. He double scouted.
Yeah.
Originally, the first probe went on the bottom right hand side, so no matter what here, he was always going to find Violet early and go for this and commit a lot to it here.
And Haas coming in with the second probe on the low ground, throwing down more cannons. There is no way Violet is going to break this with drones alone. His spawning pool has finished. He's going to start up Queens and Zerglings and dropping a Roach Warren. Looks like, he's going to go for the slow breakout. He realizes he can't do this. He's just going to keep attacking.
Oh, he's an artist. He's just an artist.
Throwing down the pylon the exact second the previous one dies. The drones don't even get a chance to get in there. The drones are forced to pull back, and Haas now getting that extra cannon up. The question is, can that cannon that's finishing, can it actually hit the hatchery? Okay, just barely crit. Okay.
I feel like I'm watching a Picasso, man. This is just beautiful here.
Oh, Zerglings do slip by. He's going to be able to run over to the other side of the map.
I mean, it has. He has a wall of back at home. He's ready for everything. He's mining gas, gets the cyber core. He's going to chrono-boost out a Zealot, get the wall with the probe. I'm guessing maybe have to throw down the pylon if the Lynx try to get in. But, I mean, that hatchery is dead.
Yeah.
And Violet's going to be locked up at home for a long time.
Yeah, that hatchery is going to go down for sure. Of course, no Nexus down for Hass
pylon
behind us just yet.
He's going to have to start a pylon before the Lynx get in.
Oh, the Lynx! Okay, very nice wall off there by Hass. And the Zealot comes out just in time.
If I was Violet here, I'd be defeated already. This is
a
disaster. The Roach is running to the cannons.
He's down 6 workers already, and losing the hatchery is going to be a real pain. And Hass goes for Stargate before Nexus behind this. He's just going to keep the aggression. But oh my god, great focus fire on the cannons. Look at this. Hass actually killed 2 of the Roaches very quickly and continuing to focus fire, ignoring the Broodlings, going for the valuable units at the back. Hass is microing this very well. Violet's going to pull back that weak Roach.
Yeah.
Does manage to save that last one, but already the trading here has been fantastic for Violet. Doing very well for himself.
Has not only has started a Stargate, he started his Nexus at about the same time that second hatchery started. And I mean, your mind has been blown, and there's nothing else that he could show you that you would think is crazy. He throws down 2 more Stargates.
You know, this is a really cool style, which we saw popular for about a week on Korean Ladder. I think it was Stats tried to use it in Pro League one game, and it was like against Bial or someone.
I mean, Violet's so far behind, the third base being on threat already. Queen's got sniped. And now he's going to be more drones dying. Look at this guy. I can't even believe it here. He's like, Oracles and Hass. This is just too much.
That was like the pace of anyone watching Hass game right there. That was too perfect. I can't believe that. Oh, my God.
Oh, that was so good. I'm glad they caught that. His jaw is going to keep on dropping lower and lower as like the game's progress here with Hass.
Mass
up
Oracle.
Until it detaches from his face.
Oh man, I mean, Violet's in a desperate spot right now. He's gonna. Oh, nice save on the probe. Walls itself in with a little pylon trick there. Hass has got all the players today, and he's still got almost no ground army.
His oracles.
He's got what, 1 Zealot?
Oh, Violet sees them with the Lynx here running around.
Uh-oh, Queen's trying to start up. The Queen's are trying to gather, but he's got to stay at the spores. This is such a desperate situation. These Oracles can just dive on top of those Queens and blast them down. You got to get next to the spores, Violet. You can't fight in the open. There's the Oracle's going to focus down these Queens. They just disappear.
Wow.
Even going to focus down this Spore Crawler. 2 Oracles do fall, but the last Queens are falling. The spores going down, and now it is a drone massacre, Todd.
Yeah, absolutely. There's not much Violet can do. He's got the last Queen and a Spore coming up that's going to die pretty much instantly. Violet down to so few workers. Hass has been running the show, and at this point he could even go carriers if he wanted to, but he's messing more oracles to try and finish this game.
Whoever said oracles don't kill hatcheries, when you've got 7 of them, yes they do. The natural hatchery goes down. Good focus fire from Violet to snatch an oracle, but when you're down to 2 base versus 3 base, you're opponent this mass oracle and all you've got is 2 queens that shoot up. Things are not looking good for the Zerg player.
Oh man, he's just absolute legends. This guy, he does what nobody else can do. And all of a sudden, Violet is 40 supply behind.
Yeah.
And I don't even know what he's supposed to do
really,
here from there to
really
recover.
The battle here for Violet is to keep his mentality together while he endures the rest of the painful death that is dying to mass oracles. Because this is one of the worst ways to lose. You're playing on a stage. It's your first match over here in China. You've flown over from the US. You've got this big match, and you get torn apart by cannon rush into oracles.
Yeah.
As Violet, you've got to stay strong here mentally. Like, there's almost no way to come back. He's going to try and fight it out, which is good. He's got to try and maintain his strength, but...
The 4th Stargate! Where's the fleet beacon?
You know, apparently if you build 0 ground units, you can produce off 4 Stargates on 3 bases. He's going to have 4th base gas up soon as well.
Actually,
just non-stop oracle production, 0 transition.
I'm disappointed he made warp gates. I feel like he shouldn't even have...
Yeah.
But 4 Stargates here for Hass. Violet is starting to pop out Hydralis, which are going to be outnumbered by this massive amount of Oracle.
You
this
know,
is,
Hydras don't
this
even...
is the real Golden Armada here,
Pete. Yeah, Hydras don't even beat Oracles, man. Like, the mass Disco Ball just come in and they kill light units so fast. None of these units are light and they're destroying them. There's just too much damage output. They're too mobile. Look at that. The Spore Crawler disappears. Another drone line is forfeit. And Violet has just got to be sucking his wounds right now. The shock, the horror. Our audience just loving it, watching some Hass games here. The natural hatchery goes down, the Queens and Hydras just disappear. It's almost a vanishing act. These Oracles are magicians right now. Anything that comes out just disappears immediately. And Haas is running away with this game really fast.
I'm not sure what Violet is staying here. Maybe a little bit of a disbelief here. That pinch me so I can wake up. Haas takes map number one.
But, of course, it's getting extra spicy right now as Neeb has gone full NA. Is throwing down this cannon rush here. Now, Mana is getting on top of it with the probes. He does have one probe of his own over on the opposite side of the map, but the coverage right here at the top of the ramp here for Jagannatha is going to be pretty decent, but has he done enough is the question. More cannons, more pylons down on the bottom side here, and Neeb's going to slowly start bringing this forward. Now the forge of Mana is now complete. His own cannons should be able to start coming here. This is going to be kind of an interesting position. I mean, the damage has kind of been done here for Neeb, though. One pylon up on the high ground. Now Mana's going to be forced into trying to zone this out, and this is such a bad position for him to try and play from.
Wow. Gets the Zealot with the probe. How about that? How about calling that a bit of micro right there? Mana does have that defensive cannon, of course. Neeb still trying to make something happen here on the top side. Trying to get his way into the mineral line right here. May still work out. I mean, the cannon, one of them is done right now. It's looking rather dicey right at this moment.
Oh, I mean, this is going to be clearly taking us to a game number three. Mana hasn't done what he needs to get this stopped, and the one cannon up on the top hasn't even taken any damage yet, Kozan. I mean, yeah. I think Neeb has done it at this point. This is a tough spot for Mana to try and play from, but at least he's got another game.
He will just defend with the cannon at home, and watch this. He's going to, I don't know what he's going to, yeah, cannon into...
I don't understand what's
maybe?
Going on. Okay.
Yeah, just
the gateway.
Yeah, dude.
Now
just
the lings are gonna go
make 400 sellouts here. Yeah, why not? Look at that, parting with the winning record and Legacy of the Void, even 2-1.
Oh, look at this. He goes around. Oh no. Well, the idea was there, but yeah.
Sue thinks he's so clever.
Doesn't he, Tasteless?
He does. He's like, oh, not this time, party. Wah.
Like that?
Just like that.
Yeah. This is like, okay, hold on.
He gets the block.
Yep. Back off, bro. The gateway's going to finish here.
Now, is he reading this correctly? Because he goes up the ramp and there's no gate. So you're like, okay, well, there.
Is he going to slow crawl this with?
Yeah, dude. You remember that.
But can it, does it can't.
Yeah, actually, I think the link
I think it does
that.
Not cover that. Barely.
It barely doesn't.
I feel like the cannon should shoot farther, but I think it actually doesn't.
Yeah. Do you remember we were talking about the other day?
Oh.
Oh, wow. It just barely
wow.
does when they're
of course.
Attacking.
Of course it does.
Yeah, Parting would know
Parting
that.
Parting knows how to do that. But Roach Warren.
Tasteless.
Yes.
We were talking about how cannons were originally going to move in StarCraft 2.
That's right.
Parting has decided that they will move anyways.
Yes.
Look at this. Literally cannon
this is
pushing.
The dirtiest thing
There's no
I've
reason
ever
why there. This should work.
Yes, this is just...
This is crazy.
This is amazing.
Like, what if you make a spine crawler?
He's made a, making a robo. He's chronoing yeah. out. Oh, my God. Look at this. Now that...
Look at that gets cover, too?
I think the corner of the pylon does it, but it's not as important now because there's a zealot out here. He's going to hit that cannon. He's getting a shield battery.
Dude. This is crazy. Oh, he did make it. He made the spine. What do you do now?
Cancels that. And this is actually in range. There's no more transfuses. This is a mistake, I believe, by Sue. He's actually going to lose that. Oh! Takes it out. Sick.
Oh, the shield battery now, barely does not
oh,
finish.
Sorry, I thought for a second the probe was killed there. No, it's still right over there. He's immediately getting an immortal out here.
Oh, my God.
This is,
I don't think he's going to be too happy to be fighting against mortals here in a moment.
Yeah, with his roaches. Now, did Sue actually see the robo? I'm not totally clear on where
I don't know.
Where his vision went. I know he had an overlord over there a while back, but...
I don't know.
Can you imagine trying to cast this game to a non-gamer?
Oh, they just
they
literally
wouldn't
understand.
They would not understand it. Yeah, they wouldn't get it at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're like, aren't shield batteries for defense? I'm like, non-gamer.
No, what a non-gamer. How embarrassing.
How embarrassing.
So this is kind of crazy. You know,
he's continuing to cannon push. He's shading into the main and killing drones. My God.
I love it. You know, Sue, this is so frustrating to play against.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You see one unit, and you're like, oh, God, I already can't kill it. And then this other unit comes in that puts it into it, carries it, and
this
moves it.
This is just some pure NA garbage, just evil. This is like you've been playing against Koreans all day, and then you queue against the best guy from Oklahoma, and this is what he does?
Yeah.
And he's like, that's right, I'm the best guy from Oklahoma. And I'm like, yeah, that's, yeah. No, I guess you can win games with this, but this is just great. And, you know, the thing is, now that the second Immortal's out here, I don't actually think it's going to be stopped. Yeah, that's it. GG.
Because he's going to be able to add additional structures.
Yeah.
In fact, he sends that second probe in now.
Yeah, he actually waited a bit on that second probe, but here we go. It's coming in right away. Look, Tex is coming in here on the low ground.
Yep, he's going to be able to make cans on the low ground. Now, this is so smart. This is so well executed because it works out as a scout as well as the ability to start the cannon. This is a great build. He's going to be able to tight wall that cannon off. He's going to be able to get that off.
Oh! He got it. And that is so far away from that main base. He cannot pull any more drones to try to get this down. It is totally blocked here. It's totally safe.
And
he
this
can
will,
now cancel it.
And this will protect the cannon push. And it begins now. The first cannon on the high ground. The second is here as well.
A third probe.
Just for extra safety to keep this alive. Because if you're going to commit this much, you absolutely cannot afford to lose. Now, the spawning pool is almost done, but it's not quite done. And I think he's actually almost going to pull a Haz here. He's going to actually cannon this up so tight that he can even start to cannon push the third base. I think that's what we're going to see here. He's actually going to try to cannon towards that third base.
That's what it looks like. He does cancel one to kind of get a better push here. He can actually get into the main.
He can kill with this cannon. He can start killing the plates. If he kills the plates, he can actually tight wall this at the bottom of the ramp. That cannon is in range of the plates. Is he going to target that? Let's see what he decides to do. He's not targeting it now. Meanwhile, gas going up here for Rogue. He starts to realize the situation becomes much more desperate with only three drones he can rely on here. Three drones can kill a cannon in the time it takes to build, but if you have more than one cannon going up, that quickly becomes a problem.
This is so annoying for Rogue to deal with right now. He's trying to do it with only three drones. He wants to keep up some sense of an economy in his main base while doing this, and just trying to barely hold it off, and then kind of get some sense of, you know, maybe some speedlings coming in here, maybe some banelings. He's getting the gas as well in the main base, so
I think he's gonna
pretty much go for anything at this moment.
I think he's going to have to cancel his base. Okay. Another cancel, of course, in response. In the wall up here, drones are moving across the map. I guess he's going to try to harass. I mean, nothing else makes much sense here. He could try to get up a forward hatch, but there's already a cannon on the way. So let's see what he decides to do with these. He might just try to go in there, put three on a probe, and then just micro them to annoy.
He's
okay,
gonna hatch
he's actually
going to
hatch. He
is
might
he gonna put down
double
two?
Hatch?
He's looking to try to do it. Yes, he will.
Okay, he's going to just double hatch on the main here. This game's getting pretty crazy. This is going to force Classic to cannon his main, and it's going to be tough. Because he can't cannon easily while there's drones in your main preventing you from cannoning. So he might even have to pull his own probes to help get those cannons up. Here's that harass I was talking about, but he's only got two.
And the positioning on the hatcheries in the main base are such that you cannot kill both of them with just one placement on a cannon here. He's going to try to kill this lower one first. Oh, he just barely saves that probe at the same time.
That's a great point that you bring up, Valdez. It's going to take a ton of cannons to cover both locations, and since we have roaches as the tech of choice here, the roaches will be able to kind of move around, use their range damage. If he doesn't stop the roaches from starting to come out, they'll eventually be able to get past the cannons and go over and start picking off those probes. Oh, one drone may go down here. Two health left. He actually could try to do a citizen's arrest. Okay, there's the quadruple cancel, or triple cancel, excuse me. He brought another drone with, or he gets another drone, excuse me, with that. And, you know, don't forget, the Protoss natural is mining. And he's got a wall and he's got a core.
Yeah, the natural's mining, the main's mining even. You know, even though this hatchery is down here, it's not... Well, I was going to say it's not really threatening the main just yet, but it's just about to be right now. He's going to make a queen here, start spreading that creep. He's got a Nidus on the way as well. Like we were saying, he has the roaches on the way here. And he's even making the speed with this.
Oh, look at this. Pulling all the probes to kill these. I think it's a smart choice, but the first roach is out. The crowd's going crazy here. Some cheers, some laughter, some sadness even, I feel.
This is
some
an
of
insane
them.
Game so far, and it's not over yet. This it still go both ways. So far, Rogue seems to have the position in the main base, getting those three spines down with the roaches as well as the queen here
and
to
the
spread
Nidus,
the creep.
The Nidus is going to become a factor here as well. Now, Since this is not the alpha of StarCraft 2, base cannons can't move because they're photon cannons, and Spinecrawlers can, so they're actually going to be able to root here before those cannons are ready, especially considering that the Roach is helping out here. You might want to move one of those. There he goes. That one was in range mistakenly, but too many probes are going down here. Classic. I don't think he has an out here, and there's the Nidus, which means more queens and more Roaches.
Here we go. So far, only three Roaches out here, but that's a lot when you have this many queens as well as the Spinecrawlers for defense. More Roaches popping out of this hatchery at the same time. Now Classic just desperately trying to hold this off with probes, but it's not looking good.
On the fly here, Rogue is able to devise a plan with those drones in order to come back and win this game. It's now 55 to 26 supply. There's no Stargate on this map, but even if there were, I don't think he'd be able to deal with these Roaches because there's too many queens trying to get these cannons up. One of them already goes down. The second one can be burst down easily. Even another Roach coming to join in. He doesn't even have to kill these cannons. He could just be harassing the Roaches, but he's so far ahead that why not? Queen's going to come down and help deal with these probes. They do a lot of damage. Can start transfusing as well once they have the energy.
The cannon goes down. More Roaches are popping out here. Even on that one base economy, you are able to get out a sizable amount of Roaches because the Protoss economy was not up at the same time.
I want to see Classic Space more than I've ever wanted to see anything in my life. There goes the Nexus. It's down. And the last of these probes will fall, as does Classic. And we will be going to an ace match. GG!